What's happening, okay? I'm Elizabeth.
And I'm Ariel, and today is Tuesday, February 14th. Juniors interested in submitting an application for Boy State or Girl State, please remember that applications for this event are due by the end of the day on Friday, March 3rd. Applications can be turned into Ms. Shell in the counseling office. If you are a junior who was unable to attend the Boys and Girls State meeting, but would like more information about this opportunity, please contact Ms. Shell at carrie.shell@ahschools.us.
After today, we have 15 days left in trimester two. That means time is winding down. If you need help, advocate for yourself and chat with your teachers and come to Lighthouse. Lighthouse is a free after-school tutoring program for all Anoka High School students. Students can get help from teachers or just have a quiet place to work. Lighthouse is held in SC 171 and SC 172 on Mondays and Wednesdays from 2:30 to 5 p.m. Students can ride the activity bus home.
Registration for spring sports is happening right now. An updated sports physical must be on file before you can register. Any questions, see Ms. Spitzka or Mr. Wicks in the activity office.
We now continue our spotlight segment for Black History Month, brought to you every day by the members of the BSU.
One of the greatest female rappers of all time, Lauryn Hill. In 1996, Lauryn Hill established the Refugee Project, which was an organization used to help and aid unprivileged youth. Lauryn Hill Press and Wyclef Jean came together to create music on behalf of the Refugee Project, creating hits like Ready or Not and Killing Me Softly. After the band broke up, she continued to make music and making another hit like Doo Wop. She also had a kid with the legend Bob Marley's son.
And our thanks again to BSU for providing us with our spotlight segment every day this month.
All senior students are being asked to complete our Anoka High School scholarship application form on Monday, February 13th. They will receive this application via email. This application applies to to community scholarships that are part of our annual Anoka High School scholarship ceremony in May. There are a wide range of scholarships that are offered and include scholarships for students who are planning to attend either a four-year university, community college, or technical college.
Attention Tornado Tales Book Club members. Our next meeting is today, February 14th, at 2:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. in Ms. Watson's room, L-135. Please remember to bring your copy of The School of Good and Evil and any items you wish to share for our potluck. As a reminder, new students are always welcome.
The yearbook staff is asking all students to check the link given in Google Classroom and help them with more student content for the yearbook. Thank you in advance, and if you have any questions, please see Mr. Palm in the LA wing.
It's time to check in on the weather, and for that, here's Scott standing by with more.
Thanks, anchors. We have a lot of rain in the forecast today. It is currently raining and will continue to rain throughout the day. It won't give way to snow overnight, but shouldn't accumulate too much. It will make for a slow drive to school tomorrow, so plan ahead. The high stays in the 40s today. Tomorrow gets into the mid-30s before a couple of cold days Thursday and Friday. It's going to be -9 on one of those days. I don't remember which one. That's your weather. I'm Scott. Now back to our anchors.
Thanks, Scott. We want to give a quick shout out to our knowledgeable team called Anoka After Dark as they get set to compete at Prior Lake in the sub-regional competition today after school. Good luck to them.
SCSU math contest registration is due tomorrow. After the three-year hiatus, the SCSU math contest is back. It's a one-hour test with lunch, activities, and awards. The contest will be held Thursday, March 30th on the SCSU campus. It is open to all grade levels. It is limited to the first 40 students, so don't delay. Registration form and $8 are due today, by today. See Ms. Manthi or stop by the math office for information.
Time for a check on sports and activities, and with that, here's CJ.
Thanks, anchors. Boys basketball is off until tomorrow when they host Centennial. The guys are 10-9 on the season. That game will be on QCTV. Girls basketball is also off until tomorrow when they go on the road to Centennial. Go out and support them in this pivotal road game. They are 14-8 on the season. The boys hockey team gave up 2 goals in the first period and took a tough loss to Roseville last night by the final 4-2. Sections are coming up soon for them as well, and of course we will keep you posted. This past Saturday, the Anoka High School JV gymnastics team finished their season. The team took a second place, just 0.3 of a point from behind Rogers. Mackenzie Rossum won vault and Cecily Fager won floor. That varsity team competes this Friday at 5 p.m. at Elk River High School in their section tournament. That's your look at sports and activities. I'm Koi. Now back to our anchors.
Thanks, Koi. Remember, if you missed anything, be sure to subscribe to the Anoka TV News channel on YouTube.
Today's lunch is Mandarin Orange Chicken.
Before we go, today is Valentine's Day. Big plans for this evening, Elizabeth?
You know, the use, I'm going to talk to my boyfriend, and then continue my countdown to June. That's the news for Ariel. I'm Elizabeth. You Stay classy, Anoka.
I used to think that I